successful, then learn from each person, each thing and each incident that happens. Good morning to you all, especially principal, headmaster, registrar, board members of the staff present over here and all my dear friends. Today in this fine morning, it's a great Indrajit would like to realize you what India should learn from the teaching of Osama bin Laden. Friends, we have forgotten not very long back, Pervez Musharraf, the former president of Pakistan, told in an interview to CNN, "I think Osama bin Laden is dead for the reason he is a kidney patient. I don't know if he has been getting all the treatment in Afghanistan. The photographs that have been shown of him in the television show that he is seriously weak. I'll give my first priority that he is dead, and secondly that he is alive somewhere in Afghanistan. But friends, come down to 2011, where Osama bin Laden was not killed in any hidden region of any tribal area, but in Abbottabad, which is just a few kilometers away from Pakistan Military Academy and where is 60 miles from Islamabad. Friends, this region is also called to be epicenter of terrorists. For example, this March, an Indonesian terrorist, Umar Patek, who had links with Al-Qaeda and the man behind Bali bombings, was also caught in the same region. Not just this, the main agent of Jamiat Islami Tehrik-e Insaf was also caught in the same region. And the hideout region of Osama bin Laden was visited by Pakistan's Army Chief General Asghar Kayani on February 1. That is exactly 1 month before the killing of Osama bin Laden. This series of incidents and proximity of Pakistan Military Academy and Islamabad show that Pakistan knew everything about the existence of Osama, and still they provided him safe haven because they know that Pakistan, he is there. And when you come, it is not only case of Al-Qaeda or Osama, and still many such leaders. For example, Abu Zubaydah was found in safe house in Faisalabad, Ranjit bin Jalsiha, the man behind 9/11 attack was caught in Karachi, and Shilak Muhammad was caught in Rawalpindi. Friends, you may call it coincidence. This is not the case because they all are found in urban cities. And WikiLeaks have been providing us now and then information about how Pakistan security tipped Osama whenever US tried to attack on them. And when you come to LET Lashkar-e-Taiba, mainly known for terror attack in Mumbai in 2008, it's clearly stated that Ajmal Qasab and his troops were trained by Pakistan's 12th Infantry Division, and the terrorist who attacked on Indian pilot in 2001 were funded by Pakistan's ISI, that is Inter-Service Intelligence. And still, mastermind behind 26/11, that Masood Azhar and Dawood Ibrahim are still safe in Pakistan. Friends, by this you should not forget, not only Pakistan, even America is your enemy too. America killed Osama because only Osama did to attack on them. Otherwise, you should never forget Osama was created by US Israel to just a former US Israel. Using Osama, they used to kill the president of neighboring countries and putting a ruthless dictator just for the sake of oil. What they are doing in Libya now is the worst situation, taking a revenge of 40 years back issue on Gaddafi for inviting OPEC countries, that is oil and petroleum exporting countries, and having raised the price of oil. Because of which, there is a massive transfer of money from Western to Middle East. In this undemocratic manner, America is killing people not for anything to say, just for the sake of oil for its own selfishness. So friends, killing of Osama bin Laden gives only two outcomes. One is that no country is more dangerous than the one which is harboring terrorist of Osama, that is Pakistan. And second one is that America is knowing that Pakistan is a country which is supporting Osama and his activities. And still, they are just looking for the potential who are dangerous to us. And still not declaring Pakistan as a terrorist nation just because they want to use Pakistan against India. And when you read the US secret book leaked in WikiLeaks, it is clearly stated never given a single chance for India to be a permanent member of UN. Friends, hearing all this, now it's your turn where you are going to be the future leaders. And even a single decision taken by you can change the fate of whole India. So never do even 0.001% of the mistake in taking any decision against Pakistan and any country supporting it, and America may top out.